God bless you, Rob Wood here of Rob Wood's Ministry. So excited to be with you here via YouTube. The search is the same, Rob Wood 1, R-O-B-B Wood, the number one. And I want to bring you a message entitled Wisdom. You know, wisdom really simply is to know what to do and when to do it. It's the application. It's taking the faith you have and putting legs to it, applying it and making it work through relevant, relatable life. And, you know, the Lord came to Solomon and he asked Solomon a question. He says, hey, Solomon, what do you want out of life? You want money? You want fame? Solomon says, no, give me wisdom. And, you know, the definition of wisdom is the power of true and right discernment. The power of true and right discernment. Another definition of wisdom is good partial judgment, or just basically simply common sense. Now, in the book of James, chapter 1 and verse 5, it says, if any of you lacks wisdom, you know, come on now, how many of us out there lack wisdom? We all lack wisdom in certain areas of our life. How do you get wisdom? How do you find wisdom? In other words, you don't have wisdom, you find it and get it. If any of you lacks wisdom, James chapter 1 verse 5, let him ask God. So that's how you get wisdom. That's how you find wisdom. Let him ask God, who gives to all liberally and without reproach, and it will be given to him. So how does God give wisdom to people? Liberally and without reproach. In other words, he just deluges it like a flood. He gives you, if you lack wisdom, you go to God, you humble yourself. Lord, give me wisdom in this area. Give me common sense. Give me the know-how of how to apply what you're suggesting to me and bringing it into the now and to bring it into fruition. Now, if you want to study wisdom, my suggestion simply to you is get in the book of Proverbs. The book of Proverbs really is the book of wisdom. Solomon really was a wise guy. If you want to be a wise guy, you know, there's a saying out there, you're a wise guy. Well, if you want to be a wise guy and have wisdom, get in the book of Proverbs. You know, I'm thinking of the wise men who sought Jesus, you know, the three wise men. But anyway, the book of Proverbs, chapter 3 and verse 13, it says, happy is the man who finds wisdom. So again, you don't have wisdom. You're not necessarily born with it, although wisdom can and is a gift. Some people just have a knack for it. It's just a gift God's given them, but you can increase and you can find wisdom and get wisdom. Happy is the man who finds wisdom and the man who gains understanding. Now, generally, in the book of Proverbs, when you see this statement, wisdom, generally under it is the word understanding. So, you know, happy is the man who finds wisdom and the man who gains understanding. So again, you don't have understanding, you gain it. You don't have wisdom, you find wisdom. And then it goes on to say in verse 19, the Lord by wisdom founded the earth, by understanding he established the heavens. Proverbs chapter 4 and verse 5, it says, get wisdom, get understanding. Explanation, you know, get wisdom, get understanding. We have to get this. We have to find this. We have to have wisdom in certain circumstances. And then in verse 7, it says, wisdom is the principal thing. Wisdom is the principal thing. Therefore, get wisdom, and in all you're getting, get understanding. Now, I'll just run through these scriptures. Hopefully, they'll help you in the book of Proverbs. Proverbs chapter 9 and verse 10. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. Now, it's not like an unhealthy fear where you're scared of God, but what wisdom does is it puts into perspective the fear of the Lord. It's like a holy reverence. You start to understand who God is, and there's a respect and a reverence. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom, and the knowledge of the Holy One is understanding. So the knowledge of God, the fear of the Lord's the beginning, but the knowledge of the Lord is understanding, to know about him, to have knowledge, to understand his ways. Proverbs chapter 16 and verse 16 simply says, how much better it is to get wisdom than gold, and to get understanding to be chosen rather than silver. So it's putting an emphasis on wisdom. It's saying you're better off having wisdom than riches, than gold, than a hard asset, than a tangible. You're better off having understanding than silver. Why? Because if you have gold, if you have silver, if you have money, if you have finance, and you don't know how to have wisdom to steward what you have, you probably will lose it and squander it. because you don't have wisdom to facilitate the thing God has entrusted you with. You see this time and time again in the natural. People win the lottery. Most people I've seen a show that win the lottery are broke in 6 months. I mean, how in the world do you win, you know, 5 million, 10, 20, 50 million, and then you're broke because they don't have the wisdom. They don't have the understanding to sustain what's been given to them, to steward to them. The book of Proverbs chapter 24 and verse 3 says, "Through wisdom a house is built, and by understanding it is established." Verse 6, "For by wise counsel you will wage your own war, and in the multitude of counselors there is safety." So I threw that verse in there, Proverbs 24 and verse 6, because by wise counsel you wage your own war. You mean, what general goes to war, or what army, or, you know, against, and they don't get wisdom, they don't seek counsel, they don't get the meeting of the minds together, they don't seek with other leaders and pick their brains, and what do you think about this, you know, in the natural that is, and it says, in the multitude of counselors, there is safety. You know, there are people that make major decisions in life, and it surprises and appalls me to a degree, they don't seek counsel. Because the Bible says, and in the multitude of counselors, there is safety. So make sure the people you're going to give you counsel, have wisdom. To give you not counsel for the soul realm or good ideas, but God ideas. They carry wisdom. You know, and again, you know, I'm doing this show on wisdom because I'm seeing a lack of it to a degree. Not only in the world's eyes, whether it's politics, whether it's, you know, different types of industries, the financial industries and Wall Street and, you know, the different financial markets, but also in the body of Christ, there are people that simply don't have the wisdom to bring to fruition what God's entrusted or the prophetic potential of God over their life. You know, the reality is, if the garbage men are picking your pails up this Tuesday and you don't put the pails out, guess what, my friend? The garbage ain't getting picked up. God's not going to send angels to go in your shed or your backyard and put the pails out. So, you know, God has given us wisdom to really accomplish and steward the gifts he's given us. Now, in the book of Luke, chapter 2 and verse 52, it said, "And Jesus increased in wisdom and stature." He increased. So again, if you're frustrated and you don't seem to have an increase of, you know, it comes over time. Jesus increased in wisdom. You know, when he was a child and when we're children, we generally don't have the same level of wisdom as we do when we're older. And, you know, there's a saying that gray hair, or people that have gray hair, which speaks of age, gray hair is wisdom, because wisdom generally does come with age. It's a learning process. "And Jesus increased in wisdom and stature with" who? "In favor with God and man." So Jesus increased in wisdom, not only with God, but with man, because he earned people's respect because of the wisdom he carried. The book of Ephesians chapter 1 in verse 17, it says that "the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give to you the spirit of wisdom and revelation." The spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of him. So generally the wisdom is the apostolic, revelation is the prophetic. The apostles bring application to what the prophets are seeing. So I don't want to go deep on you. I just want to keep this basically on the topic, the subject of wisdom. And then it goes on to say, "Eyes of your heart will be enlightened, that you may know the hope of his glory," and all that great stuff. So again, Rob Wood wrapping it up here on a show entitled Wisdom. You know, if any man lacks wisdom, James chapter 1 verse 5, "Let him come to God, who gives liberally and without reproach." Again, Jesus grew in wisdom, in stature with God and man. Again, the Queen of Sheba, when she came on the scene, she wasn't so impressed about how much money Solomon, she was impressed that he excelled in wisdom. And wisdom simply is common sense. You know, it's to know what to do and to when, and, you know when to do it. It's to know the timing of God. It's to know how, you know, if you're an investor and you don't have wisdom, you're going to get slammed, my friend. You're going to get whacked out. You'll go broke quick. You have got to use wisdom and common sense. And, you know, no one goes and invests in an investment that's not a good investment. You know, it's like you trust a guy with a phone and he's got a great piece of property. Meanwhile, it's swampland that, you know, with alligators and frogs and lizards that you can't build anything on. So you've got to have wisdom. In other words, if you're going to buy that piece of land, then you better either know the person you're dealing with, like the back of your hand, or you better go check it out for yourself or send someone to check it out for you. So again, there's many, many scriptures in the book of Proverbs, which is the book of wisdom, which Solomon wrote. He is known as the man of wisdom in the Bible. He had tremendous wealth, tremendous capability of stewardship that God entrusted. And the reason why God entrusted Solomon with the amount of wealth of the stewardship, because he knew he would not, it would be not be aborted, it would be sustained. So again, hey, be blessed. Rob Wood or Rob Wood's Ministry signing out here. The search is the same on YouTube. Rob Wood 1, R-O-B-B Wood, the number one. God bless you in Jesus' name.